Have you ever thought how players like Cristiano Ronaldo, Angel Di Maria, Radamel Falcao and many more reached that glory? Well, obviously with their hard work and talent, but there is one man who helped all these players in the pursuit of their stardom. Hello guys, I am Akash here again with this new video on the man whose name resonates in every corner of football world, especially during transfer windows, super agent Jorge Mendes. There is a saying in football world that if Jorge Mendes represents you, then no club can reject you easily where Mendes thinks you must go, except you are Florentino Perez of Real Madrid. Now you may ask, why do players actually need agents? Well, I can give you three reasons in support of this. Number one, agents can conduct potentially fractious negotiations, allowing the player to not be distracted from their job of playing football. Number two, agents regularly negotiate, so they are much more accomplished in the art of negotiation, which can even let player earn more. Number three, they advise players with many other things. So if a player wants to play football without distraction and side by side he wants to earn money with fame, he must hire an agent, or I can say a super agent like Mendes. Now you can say why he is a super agent. First, let me introduce some of his few players. De Gea, Thiago Silva, Pepe, James Rodriguez, Nani, Angel Di Maria, Diego Costa, and yes, last but not the least, the king of football players, Cristiano Ronaldo. These are just few players from the diamond mine of players of Mendes, and not to forget the special one, Jose Mourinho. So if you are a football fan, you already know the stardom of these men. So how Jorge Paulo Agostinho Mendes became super agent Mendes? Well, it was not that easy for Mendes. Mendes was born in Lisbon in January 1966. His father was an oil industry worker. Left Portuguese capital aged 19 to enter the business world in the northern town of Viana do Castelo. A video club which he opened became a successful venture, and soon he would meet Portugal keeper Nuno Espirito Santo in a disco which he was also running. A former unsuccessful semi-professional footballer himself, Mendes sent cultivating close links to players, creating his own network. So Mendes wanted Nuno to join Deportivo La Coruña, so he drove 300 kilometers from Castelo and waited every day to speak to club president Landoiro. And finally, Landoiro agreed and signed Nuno. Mendes didn't take a penny from Nuno deal, and pair became friends for life. It was just a start for Mendes. He took advantage of a fallout between Porto president Pinto da Costa and that time leading Portuguese agent Jose Viega. Finally, his players like Costinha, Jorge Andrade, and then Deco joined Porto. Later in 2002, he also had a fight with Viega, grappling each other on the floor. In summer 2002, Mendes made first Premier League deal, taking Hugo Viana to Newcastle FC. Then that September, 17-year-old Cristiano Ronaldo ended his contract with Viega and joined Mendes. In a matter of few months, Ronaldo joined Manchester United. Later on, Mendes oversaw the transfers of Nani and Anderson to Manchester United. In 2014 summer window, he brokered four of the seven biggest deals of the year. James Rodriguez to Real Madrid, Angel Di Maria to Manchester United, Diego Costa to Chelsea, and Ezequiel Mangala to Manchester City. Mendes has been named Best Agent of the Year at the Golden Soccer Awards six consecutive times from 2010 to 2015. He also heads the Gesty Feud company founded in 1996, which provides agent services for footballers. So what's the reason behind the success of Jorge Mendes? According to Ronaldo, he is the Cristiano Ronaldo of football agents because he is honest, sincere, and professional. He is more like a friend than an agent. Just like every other successful man, Mendes has his own fair share of controversies. Like, Gesty Feud was cited as consultancy ring that goes against FIFA regulation and helped clients to evade million in taxes. Still, it's just an allegation. He faced Portuguese tax probe over image rights and third-party ownerships. His name was also there with Ronaldo's tax evasion allegation, which Spanish authorities are still examining. Allegations and legal fights with other agents is common for him. Still, this man takes players' career to another heights. But there is one exception also. Lucho Gonzalez, who refused Mendes when he approached him. Later, Chelsea rejected him, ended up signing with Marseille before back to Porto and winding up in Qatari League and then finally switching over to River Plate in Argentina. So I must say that love him or hate him, but this guy is a fortune maker for many football superstars. Okay, let me tell you a few amazing facts which I can bet you don't know. Like, Cristiano Ronaldo was almost signed by Atletico Madrid, but later Mendes cancelled that deal in favor of Manchester United. Mourinho signed a deal with Real Madrid right after winning the Champions League with Inter Milan. Yes, exactly the same night. Ronaldo celebrated his move to Manchester United all alone. No one was with him on that special day. And the last one is, if it wasn't for Mendes, Fabio Contrao would be a sailor. It was Mendes who showed the confidence in him, and finally, he led him to the glory. So this was the short story of a self-made man who had nothing, but he fought against the odds and reached the heights of success because he believed that nothing is impossible. Trust me, nothing. So this was a small story of super agent Jorge Mendes. If you like my effort, please like this video, comment and share. And please subscribe to my channel for further videos. I'll come back again with more videos regarding different aspects and personalities of football world.